Hi, I'm Jen Chong and I am a hardware engineer at Keysight Technology. Today I will present to you the E36312A, a 3-channel programmable DC power supply with its built-in data logger capability. That also means, while typically most test applications involve powering up a DUT with a power supply and taking measurements from it with an external data logger, you will need just one instrument to do both of those functions with this model. First, let's plug in a USB stick. You need one with at least 7 megabytes of free space. Then, press the data logger soft key to get into the data logger page. On this page, you can choose what you would like to measure from any of the 3 channels and display the trace in graphical format. Next, press the properties key. Here, you can configure the power supply's vertical and horizontal settings such as volts per division, voltage offset, time per division, and time offset. Let's go ahead and press lock setting. Here, you can set both the durations and interval for data logging. With this power supply, you can run data logging with interval from anywhere between 200 milliseconds to 60 seconds. I'm going to set the data logging durations to 20 seconds and 200 milliseconds interval. Next, let's configure the trigger source. We can configure trigger source as run stop key, which is equivalent to this key, DIO trigger in, which is going through the digital IO pin, or remote key where you can send command through Skippy. I will choose run stop options to manually trigger the power supply to start data logging. We can also set the log min max value. When this is enabled, the minimum and maximum value will also be recorded. Note through that this will triple the file size as you can see from the required memory. Bear in mind that you can't exceed 7 megabytes. Size is dependent on the configuration selected, such as the number of traces, durations, and sample period. Finally, under file selection, you can choose to change the file name from the default name. I would recommend checking the append date time options to avoid overwriting your data logging file. Now that we have got the data logger set up, let's run the data logger. As you can see, it's starting to capture data and we have about 10 seconds remaining. Okay, our data logging is complete. Let's press auto scale so traces would auto scale and display nicely in the graph. If you click on waveform setting, you can change the vertical and horizontal settings easily by selecting the plus or minus key. If you want to, you can also capture the waveform shown on the screen and have it saved to the USB drive. Just press the meter view button on the power supply here for more than 3 seconds and the image file will be saved to your USB drive. Alright, let's export all the captured data to CSV format. Go to the properties, file selections and export file and press export. Once data has been exported, pull out the USB stick and plug it into your PC. As you can see, there are 3 files in the USB drive. There's the screen captured, the D-log binary file, and the CSV file, which we have exported earlier. Let's open the CSV file with Excel. You can see that data is logged in rows at every 200 milliseconds interval. Each column represents the different parameters captured in the data logging exercise. Further details analysis can be carried out from here. That was a quick overview of the data logger capability in the E36300 series power supply. It's useful in applications that required both a power supply and a measurement device, and it's really easy to use. I hope you enjoy the video, and thanks for watching.